Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let me go.
We'll not let you go.
Let me go.
We'll not let you go.
Let me go.
Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia.
Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. For me.
Reckon Queen's Brian May joins us now. How, congratulations.
Who were those young boys? Thank you very much.
Very well done. Is it true? Now, I don't know, we were having an argument about this before because Richard swears that he saw Queen.
I saw it in Hammersmith in 1975.
You would
perform it live?
We never performed the whole thing live. No.
What, that was very
we used to do the beginning and the end, and we used the middle bit to go off and change frocks. And there was never any pretense that we would actually do the middle bit because it's multi-tracked.
But I sworn I saw Freddie Mercury behind a white screen in silhouette.
Oh, we did do that bit. Yes, we did. Yeah, we did a lot of silhouetto things. That's right. Yes, we did. Yeah.
Right. Good. See.
But, so, what do you do in the what do you do in the musical with it then? Is that live?
Well, it's a secret. You have to come and see. But really, Bohemian Rhapsody is part of the thread of the story of the musical, even though it's set in the future.
All right, let's talk about the musical in a second. Let's talk about this chart thing first. Did you expect to come number one?
I wasn't really aware that it was going on, to be honest. I mean, I'm thrilled. I mean, we're all thrilled. It's great to be that current at this point in time, and the timing's great, obviously,
to beat
for the
Beatles
musical.
And the Stones and Robbie Williams.
Yeah, I wouldn't regard it as beating, really, you know. It's nice to be... OK, it's beating. I'm the biggest Beatles fan on earth. You know, I'd have voted for all the Beatles songs.
Well, a lot of people did. If you look at the top 10, actually, which we've got here, I think they got about 4 or 5 places in it. Yeah. Whoa, these lose me, guys. Can't make themselves think. Beatles. Abba, Beatles, John Lennon, kind of.
That's right.
And there you at the top.
Yeah.
That looks good, doesn't it?
Looks very good.
Who would you have voted for?
Probably John Lennon.
Really? Well, imagine.
My favourite song is actually Jealous Guy, but it wasn't a single, so I'm not allowed to vote for that, am I?
Mind you, I mean, I'm not questioning you being at the top at all, but it is strange when
that's
you
nice
read...
of you, Judy. No,
of course not, but it is strange when you read the whole of the 100 and you find that, you know, the Spice Girls are above, you know, wannabes above Billie Jean, and David Bowie is kind of below Atomic Kitten. I mean, not that I've got anything against, but it's generational, isn't it?
I think, and in all these polls, of course, you're seeing a certain cross-section, aren't you? I don't know quite who these people were who voted, but there are always anomalies, or what we might think is anomalies, you know. It's just nice to be in there, I think, you know.
Well, what Ben Elton's done, he's kind of smoothed this whole musical together. He's written it. And it's written around your songs. It's 31 Queen songs.
At present, 31, yeah.
Might be more than
that. At the moment, it's changing night to night. Right. And we have actually taken a couple of big ones out because there just wasn't room. There's a kind of embarrassment of riches, really.
And it's set in the 300 years in the future.
That's right.
Where there are two companies. One of them's called Global Soft, and there's another company, and they both rule the pop industry by homogenisation. You can only have one or two kinds of music, right?
That's right. Well, basically one kind. These kids are ruled by being sold stuff and by the internet and just generally being bombarded with stuff the whole time. They have lost the ability to think for themselves and make their own music.
So it's like pop idols, then?
Well, I ain't saying anything. I mean, it sounds a little bit like what's happening today, doesn't it? But
it does.
This is an extreme we're looking at. And the story in the play is that a few rebels get together and they try to find out how you actually do it, how you regain your freedom and your individuality, and you learn how to make your own music
again. So they rebel?
They rebel, yeah.
Which is exactly where rock and roll started off.
Exactly, and that you've hit the theme of the thing. Well, that is the theme of the play, really. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's
have a look. It's very exciting, actually, to see it happen. They also discover clues from the past, and some of those clues are clues left by us. So this is where we fit in. Okay.
Well, one of Queen's hits was One Vision.
Yes.
Yeah. And here's a bit of the rehearsals in the musical where they're acting out the One Vision thing, which says it all. Yeah. You have to have the One Vision and nothing else, courtesy of Global Soft. Let's have a look.
Yeah.
That's your guitar, obviously, there, in the lead and the rhythm.
It is on that version, yeah. But in the show, it's totally live. Right. We have a fantastic band who play everything
live. You're not
me, no. I may go in one day, you know, and do a bit, but no, it's a fantastic band.
But your guitar has this incredibly distinctive sound, because, I mean, I suppose you could call it an original Fender, because it was made from a fireplace, wasn't it?
It's an original Brian May, I guess. It's one of the few original guitars that there are in the world, as well. I think it's me and B.B. King. Sorry, not B.B. King. Mental Block. There's another guy who did his own guitar.
Oh, Mental Block is great.
Okay. Cool. Bo Diddley. Bo Diddley made his own guitar, and I did, you know, and we're two of the only few who did.
19th century fireplace wood.
Yeah, it was from a fireplace and bits of old knitting needles and valve springs from motorbikes and stuff.
And you used to play it with a coin for a pick?
I still do.
What coin do you use?
It's a sixpence.
A sixpence?
Very cheap.
Fantastic. And that gives it a totally unique sound, your guitar.
It does have a certain sound, yeah. The guys in the show have some commercial copies of my guitar, and they sound pretty good too, but they're fantastic players too. I mean, we're so lucky to have... This isn't like a West End band as you would normally hear it or see. You know, these guys are complete musicians in the sense that they play their own thing. It's not a copy band of Queen in any sense. They play our stuff, but it's real.
Do you still miss Freddie Mercury? Right.
Yeah. I mean, it's like losing your parents or your family or something. Yeah, I mean, it's not every second of the day, but it's definitely every day there will be a moment when you think, something strange happens to you. And obviously, particularly doing this, he comes up all the time. Roger and I both feel that he's kind of there. We feel like we can feel what he would like and what he wouldn't like and what his contribution would be. You know, he's kind of there with us the whole time, in a sense.
Were you in the room when he came in to tell you and the rest of the band that he'd composed this incredible thing called Bohemian Rhapsody? Was it on a telephone directory he'd written it?
Well, he used to have some notepaper from his dad's work, and he would sketch out all his ideas on there, including the notes of the harmonies. And we don't do dots, really, but we do A-sharps and B-sharps and C-sharps and things, and it would all be written out and all the words and everything. And Bohemian Rhapsody was totally in his head at that point. He said, yes, I can hear what it should be. This is how it goes. This is the backing track. And, of course, the backing track was piano, bass and drums. It wasn't me, so I'm in the control room, you know, helping to make sure the sounds are right and whatever, and it's going doom-doom-doom-doom-doom. Gap, and I'm thinking, what the hell is this, you know? And Fred goes, don't worry, I know what's going in here, this is the operatic part, darlings. And we went, okay, fine.
We've got two presents for you.
Oh, yeah.
Because you're a big Star Wars fan, aren't you? And you've got all the old figures.
I have. Well, we'll have to give it up, though.
Going to start off your collection of the new figures. This is Anakin Skywalker.
Could be very dangerous to me. Thank you, how very nice.
And Obi-Wan Kenobi, as a young, still, unspoiled man.
He's not a Jedi yet.
No.
Yeah. Fabulous. Thank you very much. You're very kind.
The new film's supposed to be fantastic.
Yeah, we're competing our first night's the same night as theirs, isn't it, in this country? Yeah. Yeah, the 14th.
Good timing.
Yeah, great. Yeah.
Where do you keep them all, by the way, your Star Wars?
I have a Star Wars room now. My kids think it's very funny. But, I mean, it's become a drug, actually. I'm going to have to give it up, I think.
No, because,
you can't have too many. I have enough obsessions in life. Anyway.
And Queen is actually playing for the Queen later this year.
We're doing the Jubilee celebrations, yes, that's right. The rock and roll queen.
Is she a fan?
Do you know, I've never met her. I've met almost everyone else. I've met Charles a few times, of course. He's a fantastic bloke, I think. And Diana, we were incredibly fond of Diana. The Queen I haven't met, no, and I don't know if she's a fan or not.
But you say she's a rock and roll queen.
Well, in a sense she is, because, I mean, her reign is totally the rock and roll years, isn't it? You know, it's 50 years of rock and roll. And so I'm going to be up there playing, and I'm going to think, I'm going to play
for
the Queen.
Don't you long, if she's on a journey through a city or whatever, when she's in that glass Rolls Royce, you know, or the glass roofed Rolls Royce, don't you long to shove a CD of Bohemian Rhapsody on when it gets to the rocky bit, and you see the Queen doing a bit of headbanging in the back? That'd be something.
I'm going to see if I can have a secret conversation, see what she thinks.
When's your opening night again, Brian?
May the 14th, that's the opening at the Dominion Court Road.
Okay, well, very good luck with it, and it's great to see you.
Thank you.
And congratulations on being Britain's number one single of all time.
Brilliant.
Fantastic.
Thank you, folks.
Good stuff.